We probably have readers at our site who also read at other sites. And I'm not discouraging people from reading at other sites. You can actually get some pretty interesting insights at other sites that you won't catch by us, because we basically won't let people post once they've smoked. We have a totally nicotine-free group, meaning once someone takes a puff, they've got nicotine in their system, they're unable to post anymore. And some people feel like, well, you're not really learning then, you know, the valuable lesson that relapsers can teach. Well, we actually don't feel relapsers teach that much of a message. Really, you know, you can learn from all the past relapses that our members had, but you can't learn from future relapses. So, yes, you can go look at other sites and get some insights about relapse. But if you're going to spend time at other sites, we want you to understand some of the limitations. The biggest one we feel is that you're going to get a false perception of how long withdrawal is. The reason being is when people are basically going through what we're prescribing, you know, get off nicotine, get off for 3 days, it starts to get better, get off for a couple of weeks, there's no need physical for nicotine whatsoever, and you're breaking a lot of associations and triggers up front. When you're dealing with other sites, though, oh gosh, these people are kind of in withdrawal, sometimes for months, and sometimes longer, because they're using nicotine replacement products, they're weaning down on cigarettes, they're off for 2 or 3 days, or 4 or 5 days, they slip, that's the word they'll use, they'll slip, and then they'll just start over again, and sometimes they don't count the slip, because it was like, oh, it was only 1 or 2 cigarettes, it was only a few cigarettes, and they, you know, there's that constant debate, should we reset the quit meter, shouldn't we reset the quit meter, and you get people coming in on both sides, and often, you know, you don't reset the quit meter. So now what happens is you're coming in as an observer, you're seeing a person posting saying they're having this terrible withdrawal and this symptom and this emotional reaction, and their quit meter is showing they've been off for weeks or months or, you know, who knows how long. And, you know, these people may not be off for weeks or for months. These people may be off for a matter of days, literally, since that last cigarette. Or, again, they're using nicotine replacement products. They're still in withdrawal. And you don't see that. All you see is their quit date. So when you read at other sites, you need to understand that what you're seeing there is going to be different than what you're seeing at our site. Unless you're going to spend a lot of time researching the individual, going through all their past posts to really see when's the last time they had a cigarette, you may very well get a very false perception. So, can you read at other sites? Yes. Can you get interesting insights of those other sites? Yes, you can. If you really understand what's happening and what you're witnessing, you'll often realize people suffering longer, people not succeeding in larger numbers than you would think is right, and you'll start to realize that you're glad you took the route that you did. You're glad you followed the advice that we laid out, because the advice that we laid out brought you success. And the fact is, the advice that we lay out brings everybody success if they follow the advice. Because when it comes down to it, we work by some pretty simple advice. That advice is, if you want to quit smoking and stay off over the long term, it's as simple as making and sticking to a personal commitment to never take another puff.